My name is Supha Xayprasith-Mays. I am from Fort Smith, Arkansas. When I first migrated here as an immigrant, my mother brought my sister and I was 6 years old, to Fort Smith, Arkansas. And, I call this home. Arkansas is home to me. It's where I grew up, where my kids were born and raised. I actually went to school in Fort Smith from elementary to junior high. And then I have four kids. I have three boys and one girl. My kids, as I expressed to you earlier, they grew up in Northwest Arkansas. My son and my daughter, they all went to Bentonville. So I would say, I started my career in Bentonville, Arkansas, working for the number one company in the world, which everyone know as Walmart Stores, Inc. They're at 702 Southwest 8th Street in Bentonville. And that's how I started my career, but I've been in retailing since I was 17. I've been married for over 15 years, and I got divorced. I was a young single mom. Let's put it that way. It's just my son and I. And in Fort Smith, I remember I was, as a single mom, you struggle to make ends meet, and I've been on the program to where you need assistance, but I was ashamed of it, so I ended up working four jobs. I worked at the doctor's office where I did medical billing for Medicaid, Medicare, and third party. I also worked on the weekend for JCPenney part-time, and I translate for the courthouse when they needed me. And in addition to that, I did skincare for New Skin back in the days, just with my aunt and my friend, just to make extra money. As a single mom, we needed any extra help. And then I got an opportunity where a friend of mine said, you know what? You're really good at what you do, and you love people. You should come and work for Walmart. And that's how I end up at corporate and Walmart in my early 20s. I started at Walmart and had an opportunity. I worked, as a matter of fact, in the people division. So I had an opportunity to work there and move up the rank to running a $100 million operation for Walmart. I was barely 30 years old. My husband, I met the judge when I was coming back and forth from Bentonville to Little Rock on the Martin Luther King as a commissioner. So at the time, I was an entrepreneur. I had a Thai restaurant and a retail store downtown Bentonville. And I would come up here for my quarterly whenever they had a meeting, and we would end up running into each other at different events. So my husband is super amazing. He's a civil rights lawyer, a former Supreme Court justice appointed by President Clinton. And he loved his community. He's supportive of everything that I want to do. And likewise, we support each other. And he's just super amazing. He has a practice, his law firm of Mayburn Associate here in Little Rock for over 50 years. He's been in practice and he's still practicing law. And very involved with, he's also the chairman for the Historic Black College, Arkansas Baptist. And we just try to support each other and support our community and to keep hope to those that might feel like they don't have any, that you can do whatever you want, no matter if you're from a single parent or you have no parents or being raised from your grandmother or your aunt or uncle. Because my company, we do a youth empowerment, which my husband is one of the key speakers. We bring Governor Asa, we bring corporate Walmart executive, we bring small business, we bring diverse professional doctors, teachers, professor, just to talk to the student, to let them know that if you want to go to college, how can we help you? I love business. I understand being an entrepreneur and free enterprise is the best way to get out of poverty. And I learned that from my mother, who came to America as an immigrant, just came with her four children. Like I said, I was six, my youngest sister, 18-month-old, and she even brought her little brother and sister. Her brother was like barely 12 and her sister 17. So imagine this woman who came from another country to America.
So let's stay on the topic of economics. As governor, how would you balance the budget?
Well, running a government is like running a company. You have to make sure you understand all the funds allocation, whether it be education, Department of Health, highway. You have to take a look at that and see which area that need money to be funded. Like education, we rank 45th.